Hello. I'm going to talk about Windows Update because there's a particular error which had me stumped on a computer for a long, long time. Windows was trying to upgrade to Windows 10 and I kept on getting the error. It failed 0x80070005. That is 0x80070005. And no matter what I tried, I went to various websites, tried all the various things that were recommended. No luck. I fixed it in the end with, well, the last thing I tried. The sixth thing I tried, as it happens. So I'll tell you that first. And what I'm going to do, I haven't recorded it, because I was messing about with the computer too much to record it. It took weeks, months even, with this particular machine to figure it out. Because I never had the time to concentrate on it. But I'll put little annotations on the video, and I'll make notes, leave notes in the description below for the links to the websites which have the solutions. But the way I fixed it in the end, well, what this error is usually it's an access denied type of error. 80070005 is normally some sort of access denied. And what I eventually found was that I'd go to start the update and the circle would go around and it would fail sometimes right away or very quickly. And I discovered that actually it was not downloading the update file, and that was its issue actually on this particular machine. And so I got around that by downloading the file myself. Microsoft has this USB distribution for their Windows upgrade. So you can go to windowscentral.com/how-update-windows-10-over-USB and make your own USB stick. It needs to be 4 gigabytes or more of an empty USB stick. Right. Stick it in. You run the little file and it will format the USB stick, stick the distribution file on it, and then you can upgrade Windows following the instructions on that website. It basically involves booting the computer from that USB stick. It'll get the file, it'll do some stuff. It'll ask you to reboot again, but it'll ask you to remove the USB stick first. Then you reboot again and it goes ahead and does the stuff. And does the upgrade. Finally, that took me ages and ages. Something's pinging in here. It's not mine. Anyway. Now, so that's how I fixed it in the end. That might be a quick way through, but there are lots of other things. What on earth is going on here? Why is everything pinging? There are some other things you might need to try, however. First, you must make sure that your machine matches Microsoft's actual system requirements for the upgrade. In particular, on this machine I had to make sure that it had 20 gigabytes of space free on the hard drive, at least. It just won't do it. It won't succeed if you have less than that. There are other system requirements, so the update should tell you if it can't manage it and tell you why, roughly. But there's more things to try. So another thing to do if it's having trouble downloading the update is to rename the software distribution folder. That is in C:\Windows\software-distribution. Just rename that folder, call it software-distribution.old, and try again, see if it works. That folder just stores Windows updates, basically. So if it's not there, Windows just make a new one. But if for some reason it's corrupt, renaming it will fix that problem. And if you won't find any issues from it, it'll just download the updates again if they're not there. If you find that works, well, you can delete the actual old folder at your leisure. I suggest renaming it in case there are some issues. I don't know of any issues that could arise, but you never know with Windows. So if it causes issues, you can rename it back again and problem solved. Another thing I tried was System File Checker, SFC slash or space forward slash scan now. Get it to scan your system for corrupt Windows files, things of that sort. And it's worth doing a full malware scan as well, because that can mess things up badly. And if your computer has been infected with malware in the past, it's possible that the malware has changed permission on some registry settings or some folders, and that's why you're getting this access denied 0x80070005 error. And you will need to reset permissions on everything. You use a program called SubinACL, and you can get it from Microsoft. It's at support.microsoft.com/en-gb in my case, /kb/968003. So you look for kb968003 on the internet, and you can get the info needed to reset all permissions on your computer. It's a bit of a technical thing. You have this long script which you put into a notepad file, you save it with a particular name. When you're saving a notepad file not as text, you have to click the little down arrow, save as type, all files. And then you put in the full name, including the dot, whatever it is. So watch out for that. You can't save it as a plain text file. It has to be an all files type. And there was another thing I tried, which was to remove the Dotnet framework and reinstall the latest full version. There is a Dotnet framework removal tool which you should download from Microsoft, and it'll remove everything to do with Dotnet framework cleanly. If you just do uninstall from the control panel, it doesn't necessarily do a complete job. Written by Microsoft, why would you expect it to work, right? So there's a removal tool to make sure it's gone completely. Then you just get the latest version, full version, install it, try again. It didn't work for me, but it might work on yours. Other than that, there's one more thing. You disable all antivirus and firewalls, including Microsoft's firewall. Okay. Go into the control panel, firewall, turn off firewall at the little link at the side. You then reset Windows Update. For this, you go to Microsoft's KB971058, just search for that, KB971058, and run that fix-it tool. It may fix everything, or it may say it has, but it still won't work. Who knows? That's what happened with mine. In fact, it produced a second error, 80070057, an extra digit on the end. I don't know, but anyway. So if that works, after that, restart your antivirus and firewall, of course. And then you run KB947821, and there's a DISM, or System Update Readiness tool, which will check your system. Okay, then turn off the antivirus and firewall, try the update again. Turn the update and firewall on afterwards if it doesn't work. Okay. I'll put a link to that article. And those are the things I try, but as I say, in the end I got around it the sort of brute force way, download the flipping update myself and run it from a USB stick. That worked. Okay. Okay, well, I hope that's been helpful. Bye for now.